The Legend of the Christmas Spider. Long, long ago, another Christmas was approaching. As every year, the wise started to clean the house in preparation for the Christ child to come and give his blessing in the midnight. Every nook, cranny and cupboard was swept and cleaned until the house was spotless. In doing so, she swept away every cobweb in the house, and the spiders had to move into the darkest corner of the attic for the time being, barely escaping with their lives. The elder spider sat down to wait until they could move back into the rest of the house, but some of the younger ones wanted to see the Christ child and the magical Christmas tree. The eldest tried to explain that they were not allowed into the house during this time, but the youngsters were adamant. They wanted to go and see. After a long time discussing, the eldest and wisest of the spiders thought they had found a solution to the problem. They would wait until nightfall, when the whole house was sleeping, and then they would sneak in and take a look. And so it was decided. Even the adult spiders could feel the thrill of this adventure, and when midnight came, they sneaked out of the attic into the main part of the house, taking care to tiptoe silently on all their eight legs, making no sound. Slowly they came up to the Christmas tree, and everyone was so captivated by its beauty that they crept up into the tree, taking a closer look at all the beautiful ornaments. They could not help themselves and started to weave their pretty and delicate webs all over the tree. They so enjoyed themselves that they danced on the branches all through the night. In the wee hours, the Christ child came into the house to give his blessing. He was surprised to find the little spiders and their webs on the tree. He knew that every creature is made by God and he loves them all dearly. Yet he also knew that the wife who had worked so hard to get her house in order would be dismayed by the pretty webs on the tree. So with his heart filled with love for them all and a smile on his lips, he touched the webs with his finger so they started to sparkle and glitter in silver and gold, making the tree even more beautiful than before. It is said that this is the origin of tinsel being put on the Christmas tree.